Welcome to Dongle Madness. For today's episode, I will be doing a review on this very special dongle from HIBY, which is FC6 Darwin R2R. Okay, so let's check it out. HIBY FC6 is a flagship dongle from HIBY. And for a flagship, I must say that the package comes in very simple, this box here. And inside the box, we'll have another box, which is a luxury looking leather case. Okay, and what's inside the dongle itself? Obviously one USB-C to USB-C cable, and of course another cable which I'm not showing here, which is USB-C to USB-A. And HIBY has been kind enough to include also this very nice looking leather case. All right, as you can see on screen right now, looking at this dongle itself, it is quite cute actually, right? In green color, Darwin color. So at the front here, we have this glass plated screen with middle button, which is I will show you later what this button does, and this volume adjustment, independent volume adjustment, up down, and USB-C female. And here we have a 3.5 mm single ended. Yes, this FC6 does not have balance port. Okay, now let's have a look at the specification itself. First and foremost, let's just talk about the architecture behind this FC6. This is the only second dongle in existence that use R2R technology. So it is a non-Delta Sigma dongle. A manner of saying is that it is actually built on leather resistor technology, which HIBY claimed to, they use 96 resistors with some tuning aspect to match the aspiration for fluid, you know, classic sound with modern Delta Sigma kind of technicalities. All right, the output level is surprisingly low, which is not even 2 VRMS. It is actually just 1.8 VRMS. And the output power itself per channel is just rated at 100 milliwatt. The signal to noise ratio is rated at a decent 117 dB. All right, not too shabby, not too excellent as well, because definitely some Delta Sigma DAC would be able to score easily above 120 or even 130 in the case of like Cyrus Logic. When I attach this FC6, immediately I will just be prompted with this HIBY music app, obviously sensing that there's a dongle attached to it, and I click OK. And then when I open HIBY Music, right, it will lock the volume automatically. See there? Okay. And the reason for that is that because everything will be controlled here at this volume level adjustment here. All right. So let's just play one music. Okay. And this is what I want to show you. Look at the screen now for the display. Okay. So it is exhibiting right now PCM. Obviously, this file, the song that I'm playing is a PCM at 48K, okay? And then the volume is at 11 now, okay? What does this middle button do? Okay, when I click on this, okay? So the first page that you see is that the filter. And the second page is pretty much the sampling mode, okay? First, the filter itself. We can actually select, I believe, at around 5 filter here, and then it was already on NOS. NOS simply means that no oversampling. So as the name implies, whatever that comes out from this phone goes to the dongle, there will be no oversampling done by the dongle or the DAC on the post-processing of the audio output towards analog signal. Now let's talk about the sound element of this HIBY FC6. How does it sound like? And starting with this edition of Dongle Madness, I have decided to streamline the way I grade dongles, making it a bit more systematic. And as you can see on screen right now, I have actually identified 10 different categories at which I will give grading to every each of them, which will accumulate to the total number. And the maximum number can be scored is anywhere from 1 to 100. And that total number will then determine the star rating of that particular dongle in question. Okay, let's have a look at the categories itself. As you can see there, from 1 to 4, it is pertains to the sound itself. Okay, so the first one being dynamic presentation. Number 2 being tone and timbre. Number 3 being note weight and density. And number 4 being technicalities. And at 5, 6, 7, it will be covering on the aspect of driving power, synergy factor, and volume management. 8, 9, and 10 covers on features, anything that the dongle might offer, things like filters, gain, or even MQA. And of course, number 9, value proposition. You know, how does the performance offered pitch against the price ask? Number 10 being power efficiency. Now, let's have a look at number 1 itself. Sound, dynamic presentation. One thing for sure, this is definitely a very neutral, transparent, and uncolored dongle. So, a manner of saying is that I do not hear any kind of pronounce or any hint of boosting, regardless from the lower frequency of, you know, from the bass region to mid-range to upper frequency. It is faithfully neutral and it does not exhibit any kind of extra energy or aggression to the sound itself or any kind of coloration. Just make it simple. So that's definitely a huge plus already in my book. And then number 2, tone and timbre. Perhaps this is one of the key thing which matters a lot to me. With regard to tone and timbre, definitely I would say that being an R2R dongle, this is one of the very few dongle that can offer analog sound. Organic, smooth, and without any hint of sounding digital. So if anybody knows me, those sort of features are something which I highly treasure. So this is definitely one of those dongle which are capable of delivering analog, organic, and smooth sound. Number 3, okay, note weight and density. One thing for sure, FC6 is one of those dongle which offers rich density to the sound itself, to the body, and the way it presents the dynamics and everything, the transient, it is fluid, at the same time, it is rich. Okay, so on that regard alone, definitely this is one of the best. Okay, and number 4, technicalities. This thing is definitely an excellent dongle when it comes to technicalities. First, sound stage. It feels spacious. It feels like, you know, very open, in fact. And precise, perhaps not the widest sounding sound stage I have heard so far. Okay. But it is definitely one of the most spacious sounding that I've heard, especially considering that this is R2R technology, which tend to be a bit frontal with the presentation. And that's soundstage. Spatial positioning, imaging, resolution, definition, speed, and details handling are definitely top-notch on this HIBY FC6. So that's pretty much on the technical side of it. Then, driving power. Now, this is perhaps another interesting part. You see here? When I test my dongle, I always try to push them to the max. Despite the seemingly low power output as exhibited in the configuration that you have seen earlier, just at 1.8 VRMS, and also considering that it only offers 100 milliwatt of power per channel, I was totally surprised to hear that this Hi-Fi Man HE400 SE that I have, the hardest to drive headphone in my collection, this magnetic planar sounds so full and engaging. It does not lack in the term of note weight, density, and presentation. It does not sound hollow. It does not sound lean to my ear. At least to my listening capability, I am completely satisfied with the sort of performance delivered by this Hi-Fi Man HE400 SE when connected to this FC6. Yes, I do need to push it a bit higher. It's pretty much close to around 75%. But once the proper listening loudness has been reached, the sound is just simply full and engaging. So that's pretty much on the driving power. Okay, now, synergy factor. Okay, before I go through the synergy factor, you must know that what sort of IEM and headphones that I use. as you can see on screen right now, with all my listening equipment that I have shown you there, including my headphone just now, what I'm hearing is that a very versatile presentation, which just simply sounds so very fluid and so very symbiotic in a manner of saying that, you know, it sounds right at home with every each of them, retaining their own sound signature. Because again, as I mentioned earlier, this thing is transparent. It does not color anything. So whatever I'm hearing is that the true nature of those partners attached to it. Volume management is a big deal to me. I already mentioned earlier that this is independent. It does not depend on the host to provide the volume management. It can operate on its own. Despite not having 100 steps like Kain RU6 or even, let's say, iBasso DC03 Pro, efficiency on the volume itself is something which I really love about this FC6, and definitely it scores very high on that point as well. HIBY FC6 offers features that really matters. First and foremost, I have already shown you that by pressing this button, and then you can select 5 different filters. And of course, there's an option to run oversampling and non-oversampling on the fly. Very easy, in fact. You don't need any kind of app. You just can do it straight away from this dongle. And then, of course, another feature which is kind of like really interesting, considering that this is not a Delta Sigma DAC, I am quite surprised that HIBY managed to squeeze in MQA features into it. Yeah, that's kind of like really interesting. I have tested it extensively, and I must say that definitely I am just so happy that FC6 was able to run Tidal Masters rendering really well. Number 9, value proposition. Let me just put it this way, straightforward. HIBY FC6 is not a cheap dongle. This is in fact a flagship grade dongle coming from a big brand like HIBY. And not surprisingly, the expected retail price would be anywhere from 250 and above. And believe me, there are many other dongles, a few other dongles in the market right now that ask even higher price tag. But for some people who are looking into budget solution, this is probably will not fit their requirement. But to me, at least from the price to performance ratio, that price is justified for something which is very solid in terms of build, engineering, package, and most importantly, the performance of the sound itself. Okay, so that's value proposition. Now, moving ahead to power efficiency. Perhaps the only critique that I would have for this FC6 is that power-wise, this is not very efficient. In fact, when I did my test using my phone here, right, it was only able to score 9 hours of continuous runtime in USB exclusive mode, driving 32 ohm. So let's just quickly recap. So what does it mean? It means that this is definitely a 5-star dongle for Dongle Madness. Okay, now let's talk about comparison. How does this HIBY FC6 compares against the rest of the competition? Up until now, Dongle Madness has covered over 130 dongles since almost 2 years ago. And that's a lot of dongle to compare, actually. But let's just make it simple. We already know that this is a 5-star performer. So it only makes sense that I would be comparing this FC6 against my all-time favorite of Centron's DACPOT HD and Kain RU6. This is another R2R which was released over a year ago. And if you look at my ranking, this is basically number 1 and number 2. But now, where does this place? Okay, let's just put it this way. In order to make a bit, to get a bit of clarity on the positioning, have a look at the screen right now. How do they score individually on each of the 10 categories which I listed earlier? As you can see there, right, it is very tight, very, very tight. However, the final number which surprised me, even me, and I must concede that actually the end number FC6 win by 1 point against DECPOCH HD. Yes, that's kind of a bit unexpected, because when I receive my FC6, I do not expect FC6 to be able to perform up to that level. Because perhaps you have heard me say this a few times, even in Facebook or even forums or in communication anywhere else, that it is unlikely that any new dongle would be able to match this DECPOCH HD in terms of sheer performance, because this class A is just simply outstanding. But I must say that I am happy to be proved wrong, because with proper engineering, with proper sort of implementation, something like FC6 was able to actually match and even took a bit of, let's say, superiority by 1 point overall against this one. Okay, so let's just talk a bit, going a bit into depth with the comparison itself. First, with Kain RU6. Between these two, I must say that they offer similar kind of sound. Okay, the main difference being the richness of the presentation. I must say that after using all this equipment that I have shown you earlier, my headphones, my IEM, back to forth A and B, countless hours, 4 a.m. in the morning listening, okay, A, B, I will concede that FC6 does offer slightly better in the terms of dynamic density and the richness of the sound itself. It does not feel like, you know, flat despite being neutral, because both are, like I mentioned earlier, being neutral. And when compared with DECPOCH HD, especially for anything which is, you know, already very efficient to drive, practically I am hearing a similar sort of richness in sound, the authority of the notes and everything. It is definitely something which I would consider as my favorite kind of sound. Okay, very resolving, analytical, yet highly musical. Okay, it does not sacrifice on the element of music. And in fact, if I were to reflect on my extensive A to B test, I kind of like, you know, feel that even if I were to do a blind test, it would be probably difficult for me to differentiate between the two of them, especially for some already very efficient partners. However, right, when subjected to driving something a lot heavier like this, then I will admit, right, there's a certain element that I feel that this DECPOCH HD does it better in terms of, let's say, the crispness of the decays. Okay, it is a bit more pronounced. Okay, because with something very demanding, that extra bit of power does help in magnifying the dynamic frequency. Okay, so that's pretty much the comparison, is it? But perhaps the best thing that I should mention here as well, right, we are talking about three dongles performing at the very top level right now. These are the top three of Dongle Madness out of 130. The differences between all of them are just roughly around 3 points. Okay, with RU6, 90. This one, 91. And this one, 92. FC6, just 3 points. So the rule of diminishing returns apply here. It does not mean that because I would say that FC6 is better than RU6, it does not mean that the difference is like day and night. No, it will take some very critical listening, hours on end, like, you know, in the silence of night, 4 a.m. in the morning, to be able to pick up the differences. Okay, so it is that difficult. Any three of these, I love them, all of them. Okay, I can see myself using them regularly. So that's pretty much on how the comparison for all these three, and for this FC6 against the rest of the competition. Okay, I hope this has been useful to you and informational. Thank you for watching until the end, and please stay tuned to Andy Odervoort Dongle Madness for more content like this. You have a good day there.